Welcome to the Sleuth Investing channel. What is Sleuth Investing? Why should you care? What's in it for you? Quite simply, Sleuth Investing is the methodical collection of physical information and facts about a company in whose stock you want to invest. What's in it for you? Obviously, an edge over all those who don't do it. When you know physical facts before they became blips on a screen and ink on paper, you can act before everybody else does and act on better information that everybody else has. A few obvious questions arise, which I'll try to resolve before we go into the meat of it. The obvious question is, what is wrong with just doing financial analysis of value investing? Just looking at the financial statements, the balance sheet, income statement, cash flow statement, the footnotes, everything else the company is putting out in blips on screen and ink on paper. Warren Buffett has been doing it for years. So has Seth Klarman and many other value investors. I have been doing it too. I've been a value investor for many years. What pushed me to do sleuth investing? Again, I wanted an edge. And over the last 10 years, if you noticed, many of the value investors have been finding it much more difficult to outperform the market. Warren Buffett himself, in fact, over the last 10 years, barely did better than the market. To be fair, Warren Buffett is running a few hundreds of billions. It is much more difficult to make a few hundred billions to grow as fast as mere millions or tens of millions and even a single billion. Still, my claim is that over the next few years, investing strictly based on blips and ink, even if you do it based on a CFA designation or MBA designation, is going to be much more difficult for you. I certainly have no problem with what they taught me at the Stanford Business School. I have an MBA from Stanford and I learned a lot there. But after I began to invest on my own, I realized that there's some information out there that you cannot translate to blips and ink. Let me repeat, some information, important information, cannot be translated, which gives you an edge if you look for it. But what kind of information? Well, take an example. Assume you read on the internet that the CEO of a company has said in response to an answer, in response to a question, I think that next year's sales are going to be very good. Well, if you see that, you become more confident, you keep holding to your position, and you may even add to it. However, if you've been present there and you heard him speak, you would have heard him saying, I think sales next year are going to be very good. And you also could have seen that the vice presidents roll their eyes in disdain because they don't believe it. This would have given you much more information, physical information that everybody else has on the internet. It's the same with many other kinds of information, which you will see later on. I'm going to give you examples of actual sleuths, I'm going to call them fictional, out of legal self-protection, who have made a lot of money by doing what I push you to do, not push you to do, what I recommend for you to do. Remember, I'm not providing you financial advice. I'm not giving you any financial tips. I'm only telling you about the method that you are welcome to choose to use or not. It is totally up to you. It is an educational channel, just like the book is. Buy my book and you'll see the details of what I'm talking about in many more details. Now, let's answer one or two questions about, first of all, my qualification for speaking about it. As I said, I have a degree from the Stanford GSB, Graduate School of Business, with a number of prizes. I also have a degree in aeronautical engineering. Yes, I have been once a rocket scientist. I also participated in the design of a particle accelerator, so I know some physics. You see later on, I'm using it too, to provide a scientific basis for what we are doing. And I've been investing in the market for quite a number of years, ran a number of financial companies, started hedge funds, sold a few, and I am now investing on my own, even though I really don't have to work anymore, just like many investors don't have to work anymore. Why am I doing it? Because like many other people who are in the market, I just love the market. It's wonderful. Warren Buffett once called his portfolio his canvas. Well, whether it's a canvas or it's a sport, it is something which many people are doing for fun. And luckily, it also makes a lot of money. And if you are here watching this channel, you probably like the market also. I'm going to go more and more into what we are doing. But let me give you first of all a warning. When you're collecting physical information about a company, you may end up occasionally with a piece of information that will make you a lot of money. And it's quite obvious too. At that moment, you'll have an urge to come and tell everybody how smart you are. My recommendation to you, don't. Because if you convince other people and they are going to buy the stock too, or short what you want to short, they are going to move it, and then it's going to cost you more to put another position on. The fact is, you cannot be famous or popular and rich for the same thing. You have to choose. What do you choose? Money, popularity? Trust me, once you have the money, you'll be popular enough. The other question is, why do I tell you all this? If it's working so well, why not just keep it a secret? For two reasons. The first obvious reason is that may not be obvious to you, obvious to me. Only maybe 2 or 3 out of 10 people who watch this channel are going to really go out and do it. Even though the principles are simple, to do it is hard, not extremely hard, but hard, because you'll have to do really real work. You will not be able to stay in the office anymore or at home just drinking coffee with one hand and typing on the keyboard with the other. You'll have to go and talk to real people, see actual products, go to maybe another town to see the headquarters of the company, talk with the company's salespeople, suppliers, customers, talk to some competitors, and get real physical information so you can get a gut instinct of what really is going on. But once you do, and if you get it, every now and then you are going to find that you have a gem in your hand. And this gem is a piece of information which is basically the diamond of sleuth investors. This gem has 3 facets. One is that the information has to be true. And you can find if it's true or not by looking at it yourself, not just listening to the professional PR person of the company. The second facet of the information is that it has to be important and significant. And you can only know if it's significant if you talk to people in the business, not analysts or outside observers, but people who participate in it, either the salespeople of the company, the company itself, or the competitors. So it has to be true, has to be significant, but most of all, it has to be exclusive to you. You can find on the internet quite a bit of information which is true and it is significant, but is known to everybody. Therefore, when you want to buy, you're buying from those who already know that it's valuable. So your profit can be very low, or let's say modest. This, I believe, is one of the main reasons why for the last 10 years, value investors made less and less and less money over the market. Because even though they have done the work correctly, there are many more smarty pants out there who have gone through all the MBAs and CFA and legal courses, and they do exactly what you are doing, and maybe also about the same companies. So the only way, in my view, to get an edge over the next 10 to 15 years is going to be to look for physical facts. And once you do that, basically you can do much better than you think. The second reason that I think that there's no risk of me telling you all this is because the number of foolish money, let's say unwise money out there to be taken, is enormous. Most investors in the market are agents, not principals. That is, they are high-level clerks with degrees, and with PhDs even, who are managing money that is not theirs. And they are not looking to make a lot of money. They are trying to keep their job. And to keep their job, they have to outperform the market. And the market, let's say the S&P 500, is a collection of the most famous and well-bought and well-known stocks, which means stocks that don't have much more profit in them. These are people who are going to invest strictly based on derivative blips and ink information. If you are going to get more information that they don't have, you can't avoid making money. Let me just give you one last analogy before we go to the first example of a sleuth who made $1.6 million by sleuthing a company, a mining scam, halfway around the world. And the analogy is this. Have you ever played poker? When you play poker, so they say, the first rule is to look around the table and to ask yourself, who is the sucker at the table, also known as the fish? And the rule goes, if you don't identify the sucker, it is probably you. Because in every poker table, there is a fish, a sucker whose role in life is to lose money to the other players. He or she doesn't know it yet, but that's his or her role. If you look at those who play, they all look the same. They all can look well-dressed or underdressed or bizarrely dressed, which is how poker players sometimes look. And they are all looking at their cards and they are putting money on the table or taking money from the table. But when you wait for the end of the game, let's say after 2 or 3 hours, some players end up with no money or little money, and some players end up with all the money or a lot of money. What is the difference? They all seem to be doing the same thing. My claim is that the fish, the suckers, are looking mainly at the cards and they're doing calculations before they double down or they're doubling up, before they fold or before they continue to play. While the sharks, the real competent players who over time make big money, they look not just at the card, but they look at faces and at behavior. They look at the physical evidence that will tell them what may happen in the future. He tells them who to bet against, who not to bet against, who is the one who is more likely to act foolishly, who is the one against whom you don't want to bet. In short, the fish are doing value investing and numerical investing, while the real winners are doing physical investigation and sleuthing. That's what I also tell in my book, and that's what the channel will show. Now, we are going to go straight into the first example, which will be the good preamble for telling you some details of how to go about sleuthing. And the example is about somebody who I call Chris, who, as I said, made $1.6 million in a few months, starting with maybe 20 grand. And he did it by traveling all around the world to look at a mining operation that proved to be a scam. Let's go for the next clip.